I don't necessarily disagree with you, Marble. Like, were it up to me, there would be, like... Get fire resistance. I need it. Oh, no. You see, you say that, Radiant, but now it's like, well, that's a challenge. But no, I fully believe that you are not fucking around when you say that. It's like sworn. Did I not? Oh no, that would have been what was in his inventory. I'm just a doof. Never mind. All right.
You point, I bunch.
Let me check. I'm sure I have fire resistance, sir. Thank you very much. I have one potion. Normally when you take the stuff, the door shuts. Well, that's two things that are, like, just functioning weird here. I don't know, it's... And the statue shoots you a lot. I don't know, maybe that was me disarming the traps? I don't know, I'm gonna take it.
Butt kicking for goodness!
Maybe Beamdog was like, this is just, like, too bullshit even for us, which I find hard to believe. And removed that. Who knows? All right. Seriously, guys? Oh, wait, no, I'm an idiot. Door. So distracted by... Balls resonate with the sound of grinding stone. A door is open somewhere nearby. Yeah, like maybe the door that you're standing right next to, you dumbass. So those are just fake stares of trolling. I can appreciate that. What do we got here? Know my madness. Okay. Let's see. Gems go to Viconia. Did I just give her? I just gave her a potion. Like, I'm just completely brain deading my way through this game. No, those are actually scrolls she can cast. I promise, guys. On occasion, I'm competent, but tonight is not one of those nights. But, like, one time I need it. Are these... Frost Giant? I'll give that to Minsk. I prioritize Minsk for strength potions because Dorn has a higher natural strength. He's got that 19 natural strength. So, like, going from Minsk's, like, 1830... Oh, 1893. Never mind. Minsk is a lot stronger than I thought he was. This is gonna be fun, isn't it? Oh, you guys. And of course there's loot in there. Phoenix telling me to get fire resistance. You're not wrong, which is probably why I should take him up on his advice.
There is death and danger here. Possibly destruction too. Maybe even drama.
Chunk, you take your drama and you leave it at home. This is a no drama stream. Thank you very much. Or emotion. Disturb the emotional state around affecting. Hopelessness. On a failed saving throw, lies down where they stand and give over their will to higher powers. Sometimes they can be heard to exclaim things such as, I lay down and die. Oh my. Emotion, hopelessness. Well, I think we just found a new 4th level spell. Because I honestly think that's probably going to be better than confusion. 9 rounds! Jesus Christ, where they just lie down and go full Xan on the world. This is great! Like, we have a spell that literally lets us turn things into teenagers. Oh, that room is just sadness. Go, Chunk, go! Your boots of swiftness. That is a hitchhiker's reference. Alas, it is lost on me. Oh, what is this? A giant topiary garden under here? Truly, the dude that made this place is nuts. Man. Go for the door, I'm sure it's locked. Oh fuck, it's not! Go! Skeletons? Seriously? Oh shit! acid damage? Get out of here, you jerks. How are you even hitting my dwarf? We'll take that unnecessary ammo now. Thank you. Oh, I do radiant. Believe me. That's Zan's... Okay, so apparently, Chunk was standing in just the right place to take some fire damage there. I don't know why. But yeah, Zan's other fourth level spell is Greater Malaysian, and I believe I have Edwin. Yeah, Edwin can cast it too.
You are so.
So.
I'm here to help.
Seriously? Oh yeah, I guess. Okay, the blast does come in here. It just like it terminates at all the other doors except this one because, fuck me, I guess. And that fireball's no joke either.
We're all what is it now?
Okay, so the easy solution to this in my eyes is I'm just gonna haste my party.
Yes, I'm here to help.
And we're gonna quick run. Well, everybody except Minsk is gonna quick run, and because Minsk is slow, everyone else is slow because Pathfinder fucking sucks in this game. Minsk, you get to do the walk of shame alone because I'm upset with you for fucking killing half my party. That's right, you dick. You get to eat like 70 points of damage.
Again, you deserve.
Boo gets his ass hairs singed because of you. I don't know, Marble, but I'm gonna say yes. See everybody else? Perfectly fine. Yep, you know what they're... You notice what they're not? You know, aside from aggroing a pack of greater ghouls when one of my frontline melees is half dead. Insk stand in the background, look busy. Everybody else? Do combat. Everybody should be able to run through it one at a time. Yeah. Yeah, you're probably not wrong, but if I'm given the opportunity to do something stupid, I'm gonna take it. Alright. We still have haste on us, so I'm really... Two greater ghouls doesn't worry me over much, even though they have naturally paralyzed Chunk. There we go. 1,000 XP a piece of
them. Off now, not
again. My action.
Full plate and packing steel.
Waiting for paralysis to wear off. Can I save? I can. Can I sleep? Oh! We all good? We're all good. Okay. So let's explore the topiaries. This reminds me of a level out of like Thief or something. Except I don't think in Thief there were any bodies, like, stitched to walls. That's kind of... I do not have true seeing, no. We are not high enough level for that. I think... Yeah, that'd be 9th level cleric. That's a 5th level cleric spell, I think. Ah! Yes, come after me, you shambly little creature, moving at 60 frames a second while the rest of the game moves decidedly slower. Yes, paralyze my melee. Iconia, stand around looking useless. The only thing stronger than my salt is my desire for experience points. Anything else? Oh! Crap. Yep. Ah! The fuck is that?
Spider Queen's vengeance.
A Shirukuru. Okay. And... God damn it, Zan. Apparently that thing hit her and broke its weapon, which is hilarious. Dark Malaysian, we're so good at dancing, Jesus Christ. Darker Malaysian. You may not rest at this time, my butt. That's what you need true sight for. Gotcha.
You need
yeah,
me?
No true sight at yet, once. Alas. Yeah, jump. Alright, thing hiding. Ah, there it is. No! You leave my squishy mage. He's not even a mage. You leave my squishy characters alone. We're only squishy because the developers add stats in this game like I do when I'm running a game. Never mind. Okay. You fucking dick creature. Litter dust. Will it do anything? Yes? No, yes, no. can't tell. Oh, they killed it. Chunk coming in with the critical hit for 32 damage. Just insta-gibbed whatever the hell that thing was. A Shiru? I'm Googling that. A Shiru Kuru. Apparently it's just an undead that's here. Type of undead creature found in the garden maze. Highly effective killing machines due to their repeated ability to turn passively invisible every combat round. They can backstab with a multiplier of 3, resulting in significant damage. High resistance to cold, electricity, acid, fire. Huh. They do not appear in any AD&D rulebook and seem to be designed by BioWare specifically for this game. Makes their classification problematic as there's little explanation to what they are. They are, however, affected by protection from undead and anti-undead spell, which raises a suspicion that Ashiru Kuru are some type of spectral, shadowy undead. Huh. Alright. The more you know.
You point, I punch.
You're sleeping. Seriously, let me sleep. I can't sleep, I think, when that fireball is, like, cooking up. I don't see how much that thing hit for. Because, like, that thing almost killed Dorn. 12, 21, yeah, backstab triple damage. Jeez. That's nasty. Chunk should, in theory, be doing that. I think he backstabs for, like, times 3 at this point. Yeah. But my problem is he never backstabs because I never use hide and shadows and I'm too lazy to give him invisibility. Yeah, magic missile trap. Come on, guys, get it.
Yes, at once.
All right, Chunk, detect the trap while everybody else fights. Come on. Protect the trap. Solve the trap, Chunk. Thank you, Chunk. Go forth and murder. Oh, nuts. Sleep is sadly, decidedly less useful now than it once was. Battle axe. Old monster. Somebody's complaining about something. What was that? Oh, evil is around every corner. Careful not to step any. Step in any, rather. Chunk is a fighter thief, multi-class. He's originally a character from my Might and Magic Let's Plays where he was a ninja, and since there's obviously no, like, ninja equivalent, I'm just like, fighter thief it is! And, it's a job done. Basically, the only thief I use him for is, like, traps and locks. So, like, I'm not too worried that he's not backstabbing all the time and stuff. What is this? Bala's Axe Wizard Slayer. Miscast magic affects the victim the next turn on each successful hit. Huh. Sadly, it is not otherwise magical at all, which makes it vendor trash as opposed to idle curiosity. Wow, he actually identified almost all of those. Bolts of lightning. Taking any of these stack. Nope. Chunk's class is cannonball. Accurate.
You need me?
He just goes around murdering people with that creepy fucking grin on his face all the time. This should be something like something you can at least like examine, and they give you like some creepy text, like, you know, the mouth of this skeleton is frozen in a terrified scream as, you know, thorny vines erupt from its eye sockets and forehead or something. Come on, guys, get on the ball here. Oh, no. Disarm that. Ha! Chunk's... Oh, Chunk's a quick one. He can, like, disarm those traps so fast. It's magic.
What is it now?
Let's see. About there. I think we'll probably only roast most of the party and the ghouls. Accurate. Most of the party and the ghouls. I love me some fireballs, but, like, this is not the dungeon for fireballs. Well, the only downside is, like, I wanted him multi-classed into fighter for the weapon proficiencies, because normally he fights with, like, katanas and shit, and I know those aren't, like, great weapons for these games, so, like, the ones that I do fight with, I want him to be specialized with. And just going straight thief, he wouldn't really have what I would be considering sufficient proficiencies for them until, like, Baldur's Gate 2. So I had looked at, like, the kits for thieves, but I was just like, screw it. I want him to have, you know, better Thaco progression from fighter. I want him to have the extra hit points. And I mean, all told, if I really need him to, he can be running around in plate armor and stuff.
Yes.
Like, I could just throw this on him and get him down to a negative 3 if I really wanted to. Which is kind of nice. Scroll of Ghoul Touch, which I guarantee all of you I will never use.
What could
at once?
And then silence.
This game. This dungeon. Like, this dungeon is just fucking murderous. Like, I should port this thing to, like, Pathfinder and run a party through it. I guarantee you guys, nobody would get through the second level. Hell, the things like spamming Cloud Kill on the first level would probably kill most of the group. Yeah, I hear you. I hear you, you undead crusty motherfucker. Where are you? The rest of the goon squad up here. Wait. Ah! Dickory has shown itself! God fucking damn, those things hit hard! Echo production is what the flaming fish is specialized in. Jesus Christ. Marvel, if you're gonna start chronicling all the things I mispronounce when I'm gabbing for hours at a time, you are going to have a hell of a lot of work ahead of you. Come on. Detect it. I know it's like right there. There you go. Alright, now wuss out. We need buffs.
We're all doomed.
Ah, haste. I guess that's everything. Just sending you four up there. Alright, guys.
Yes.
Light, whatever.
That is like such a cheap anime design. Woo! Dory ain't fucking around though. Just like, nope, dead. And the critter beast could not help but oblige.
If I continue with this, I'll never look whatever. In the eyes again.
Choose what could I do
carefully.
At once?
I'll not let this come to pass.
Minsk, you've been telling me to choose carefully for like the last
no pleasure in idle
many chat. Hours of gameplay. Does this actually tell me how long
Mail?
I have been?
Fetch me something to eat.
No. What if I go into save? Will that give me? No, it's just chapter time. I mean, I can go into like. And go into Steam Overlay, but Steam Overlay is like, yeah, bro, you've got like 90 hours in this game, which I obviously haven't been playing this that long.
I'm here to help.
Does not welcome me.
I'd say I'm probably. What, stream 6? Maybe. Yeah, 25 hours in, roughly. Beware a door! Man, doors are the greatest enemy. You gotta watch yourself when you're around doors. And the trickiest things about doors is you never know when they're really ajar. And that's when they're at their most dangerous. Man, I'm like terrified of everything. There's like traps everywhere, there's enemies that can constantly be invisible that will like murder half my party in one hit. Oh god, ghouls. That's like low end of terror train right there. But I still fear them when I've only got Chunk up here because his saving throws against paralysis are approximately ass. Come on, guys. Come on, guys. Chunk, return to exploring. Thank you, rest of the party. Need fire damage for one of the upcoming fights. Is something like a flame arrow or a fireball or an agonizer's scorcher going to be enough for this, or am I going to be needing it on like a weapon?
Nail, fetch me something to eat.
Oh yeah, you're not wrong, Marble. You're not wrong. People get so paranoid about like the strangest things in D&D. Like I had one game I was running, Castle White Rock. It was like Phoenix. Okay, just one. Okay. All right. Well, I can handle that because I believe both of my casters have flame arrow, and like I've got this wand of fire, so I think we'll be okay then. Thank you for letting me know.
You need me at once.
But yeah, Marble, I know what you mean about doors stopping parties. I was running Castle White Rock, which is like a canned module, like a mega dungeon, years ago, and there's this one room, and it's like in this, I wouldn't say trap-heavy part of the dungeon, but there's just this door. And like the writers took a lot of time describing this door, and my party was so paranoid, they spent like 2 hours like examining this door and everything around it for traps, and it was just a freaking door. But they got paranoid. The mask intones, down 4 tunnels, life 4 foes, kill all 4, and the game begins. Fire, ice, slime, and wind all must perish to continue. She who fires flame must be killed before her bow is drawn. Queening can change a match, much for the worse if you're the player type. The mask intones, ooze only parts before the blows and spells, but evaporates in the cleansing fire. Alright, so ooze is fire then. And I think this is the level then, if I had to guess, with the chess puzzle on it, based on how that sounded, which I'm excited about. I seem to recall liking the chess puzzle in this game. We are, however, nearing the end of the stream. I don't want to go too much longer here. Oh, that was not what I was expecting.
At once.
Yeah, the chess match. Everybody rages about it, and I'm sure I'm going to rage about it too, but... Exactly! I think it's like one of the best things out of these games. Alright. So, it's probably stupid to say so, but there don't really seem to be any traps along here, so we'll just kind of... Yeah, there's ooze. We'll just kind of fuss around here really quickly. Oh, that's polar bears.
I'm here to help.
Cauldron the bear. And a bunch of winter wolves. Sure, why not? Okay. Well, that's exactly it, Marble. Is it so, like something that looks really intimidating initially, but like once you kind of, air quotes, get it, it's a lot easier. Of course, by this point, I don't remember shit all about it. I just remember liking it in the past. So this should be hilarious. I don't know if we'll get to it tonight, but it's coming. All right, where are you next? Hey, come on. Oh my God, the bear can throw icy fireballs. One might even call them ice balls. Dogs. We got this like really, this bear is really chill, but in a dangerous way. Holy shit, you guys see how fast that thing's attacking? That bear's dynamite. Also probably hasted. Never mind. Bear's dead. Exactly. That's more or less probably how it's gonna go down too, if I had to guess. Oh, come on. Chunk, your speed is an asset, but when it always leads to you getting into melee combat first, it ceases being funny and starts getting to the point of me being frustrated because you die. Come on, guys. They're dead. There we go. Okay, God, that sound effect is deafening for buffs wearing off. Is everybody looking? Oh my God, my wizards are nearing another level. This is blowing my mind. I'm gonna have so many spells. Like this is like one of the things that always got me is like wizards are the most powerful class in the game, but they're one of the quicker leveling ones past like the early levels. It's like, you know, my melee is to hit 8th level, 150,000. Wizard, you know, bending space time for 90,000 experience points.
Once.
What are you gonna do?
'Tis akin to my home, but home does not welcome me.
That's because you're kind of well, I wouldn't say it's because you're evil, Lyconia. Maybe this game's drist analog. Oh, that's a skill. Screw it. It's a skeleton.
No.
Get it, chump. Oh, these are skeletons of fancy, but oh no. Go, chump, go. Flee for your life. It's just a skeleton, guys. Guys, these skeletons are throwing death magic and shit. No, you know what? No, eat shit and die. I got fireballs. Damn right. Showing the power of Team Wizard. Edwin, thank you, Edwin. Mirror image yourself. Stay, please, Edwin. Thank you, Edwin. All right, what do we got here? One more. That is true. And like, that's like the downside is that like both of my front row characters aren't straight fighters. Like Minsk is a ranger and Dorn is a blackguard.
You need me?
I mean, cause like, yeah, compared to a thief's gonna hit 8th level at 70,000. Like yeah, a stock fighter,
again, you disturb me.
They level quicker, but. But yes, not as slowly as a druid. Druids are,
if I must,
special. I know there's more of you jerk-offs in here. There's gotta be. Of course there are. Thankfully, I have Edwin. He's tired of your bullshit. Don't disappoint me, Edwin. Edwin, you disappoint me, and for that I use a charge of your wand. Oh yeah, that's right, they're undead and immune to cold. I'm not an idiot. Oh wait, did that thing actually deal? Oh, it's the acid damage. Okay. So say, like, how are those things actually dealing damage to Edwin? He should be immune to physical damage from stone skin. I hate you, Edwin. Edwin, you're just a fucking, you are a garbage mage. I hate everything. I don't even. I got nothing.